Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing the VE Myth Revisited: Why Most Small Businesses Don't Work and What to Do About It, book by Michael E. Gerber, Even Without You in It. It talks about this becoming your own turnkey solution so that you have a business model in place that your system can effectively reproduce as you need to. Most small business owners would most definitely benefit from reading this book, if for no other reason than the awareness of where they are and where they could be. Gerber looks at the root cause of business failure, the owner's desire to work in the business rather than on it, and provides a common sense approach to looking at the business in a different way, that of a replicatable series of systems rather than an extension of the owner. Gerber's book is a very easy read, and should stimulate your thought processes even if you disagree with some of his advice. As a consequence, the owner should devise systems to ensure consistency in execution of every aspect of the business. It takes you through the story of a young entrepreneur whose business has swamped her. This book is quite specific, and gives you details and lessons you can implement in your own business. The book puts in simple, conversational terms the mindset you need to run a successful business, and the process you need to go through to create it. You'll discover that your business does not own you. You own your business, and you have the power to structure it according to who you are and what you want your life to look like. Be prepared to throw all you other business books away after you read this one. This book is consistently in the top 10 of all business books out there, and there is a reason for that. Most business owners are technicians who owns a business, and in the end just owns a job, a glorified employee who is self-employed. Michael Gerber inks out a plan for all business: your primary aim, strategic objective, organizational strategy, management strategy, people strategy, marketing strategy, and systems strategy. Excellent book about the mindset all business owners need, no matter the size of the business. It goes beyond explaining why independent small businesses fail way more than franchises. It explains what needs to happen to be successful. Michael Gerber takes a very practical approach to explaining the difference between working for a company and running a company. A few of the key lessons from this book: if your business doesn't run without you, you don't own a business, you own a job. Understanding the technical work that a business does is not the same as understanding a business that does technical work. This is sound advice, and a proper balance of the three prevents tyranny by any one personality. There is a great deal of truth that Gerber captures and teaches, along with room for some disagreement. Nonetheless, this quick read is worth its weight in gold to the young or new businessmen. This person was able to create a successful and profitable business based on the concepts presented in this book. The first is that too many people work in their business, and not enough people work on their business. The second is that most successful businesses, regardless of their size, operate in a franchise model. Many people allow too many assumptions to get in the way of running a business. Actually, the author does not argue that you should develop and sell franchises of your business. This allows you to focus on entrepreneurial as opposed to technical matters, and keeps you from being the repository of all the expertise in the firm, which would force you to do everything in the office anyway, making employees worse than useless. Obviously, if you find yourself with an ex-McDonald's on your hands, franchising might be the way to go, but the author does not argue that any particular business should franchise, only that the franchise model has lessons to teach every business. Many of the concepts in this book should be taught in every high school, instead of letting all people be trained to be the technicians. It's funny, but stuff like writing down processes and setting up systems to help you do your work efficiently really do make all the difference. Gerber goes into detail here on how to develop a system for you and your people to run, as opposed to running in circles. Okay, so you may think that even though this book was published in 1995 that it is no longer current. Even though your top offline smartphone is obsolete in 2 weeks, there are some things that stay current, and that's how this book is written. Many of the items are back of mind are crystallized in the book, and played out with examples that are practical and easily applied. And it's the worst job in the world because you're working for a crazy man. Gerber gives a step-by-step plan for making your business find purpose and success, and how the complications of running every aspect of a business can be broken down into uniformly performed functions the way a franchise is. There is so much valuable information to help you build your business and have a better understanding of why you are in business. It's not just to make money. Read this book and find out why. Gerber explains a different approach to developing small businesses to not just survive, but with a plan to thrive. If you're a small business owner whose business is stagnant or going in the wrong direction, this book can be enormously valuable. Melinda Emerson, Small Biz Lady Author, Saw Zero Become Your Own Boss in 12 Months, A Month-by-Month Guide to a Business That Works. As a new business person, it is very easy to focus on putting out the latest fire, and letting all else pile up on the sidelines until burnout, or failure kicks in. This is a great book for the person who wants to understand what it takes to make a business succeed. Michael Gerber spends a lot of time explaining how each of these people brings something unique and irreplaceable to the process of running a business. The central theme in the book is that true entrepreneurs are rare if they ever exist. Then after the new business euphoria wears off, the technician takes over again. And since the technician is solving technical problems and not management problems, the business is managed very poorly, if at all. It never hurts to learn more about how each part works to make the whole operate. This is a great first 34 of a book, and that is a great enough reason to buy and use it. Being a good technician is the most important critical factor in having a successful small business. Likewise, that a mission tied to deeply held personal values, understood by all persons in the business top to bottom, is absolutely necessary. Great tips on figuring out your best role within your own business and how to improve the process. Most importantly, it continually reminds you of how to establish a system for your business that can be easily replicated, the ultimate purpose of which is so your business runs without you being there constantly to supervise or do the work yourself. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe and leave your comments below.